organization was formed. The First World War was began in 1914 and lasted until 1918. In this World War, there were a lot of destructions of life and property, which led to worldwide desire for peace. Yes, after the destruction, there was a desire for peace. This led to the creation of League of Nations, which was established in 1919. It had total of 63 members countries. Its aim was to protect the world from war. Yes, these were two basic causes: the failure of the League of Nations, and again, at that time, USA was one of the most powerful creation countries, and Russia were not the part of League of Nations. The League was more of an organization. Now, so the League of Nations was also failed. Now, then there was a need to solve other things. After the Second World War, countries such as United States of America, United Kingdom, and France wanted to replace the League of Nations by starting another organization, and this led to the form of United Nations Organization. So Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Winston Churchill, and US President FD Roosevelt met at San Francisco, USA, and from the Atlantic Charter in 1941. So after the Second World War, there was formation of UN. Okay, after First World War, there was formation of League of Nations, but there only 63 countries participated. It was a failure. So after Second World War, there was a charter in 1941, and this charter assisted the creation of world level organization for promoting peace. The USA, UK, Soviet Union, and China met in 1944 at Washington, D.C. and drafted a charter for the new organization. And this was the UNO, the United Nations Organization, was formed on 24th October 1945 at San Francisco. Since then, 24th October is celebrated as United Nations Day all over the world. So students, this was how the UNO has formed. The main aim of United Nations is to maintain world peace and security. Representatives of 50 countries met for 33 days at San Francisco and framed the charter. The charter contains the list of objectives and principles of United Nations. The headquarters of the UN is situated in New York, USA. So students, this was how the formation of UNO has been done. Now students will go for the objectives of the UNO. Yes, the objectives of UNO are to promote and maintain international peace and security, protect future generations from scourge of war. Scourge of war means fear of war. Ensure equal rights to all member countries. Develop friendly relations among all nations so that all nations live in peacefully in harmony. Cooperation in solving problems at international level. Yes, problems of the different countries should be solved at international level. As we have the two countries, for example, India and Pakistan, we have problems. So that can be solved at UNO. Provide a platform where all nations can discuss their problems. Remove differences of race, religion, language, and gender among the people of the world. Promote respect for human rights and freedom. So students, these are the objectives of UNO. Now we are go through the Now we'll go through the major organs of the UNO. The UNO is a large organization that provides scientific and technical expertise in various fields like agriculture, health, and education. And following are the main organs of the UNO. There are six organs of the UNO. They are General Assembly, Security Council, Economic and Social Council, TrusteeCEP, International Court of Justice, and the Secretary. We'll go through them, all these organs, in detail. First, we'll go through the General Assembly. What role is played? What is done by the General Assembly? As a chief organ is the General Assembly. General Assembly is regarded as the parliament of the UN. General Assembly is regarded as the parliament of the UN. Its session is held in September every year and continues until the end of December. So the session of General Assembly starts in September every year and continues until the end of December. Each member nation sends 5 delegates to represent their country. Delegates means officials. They send to the nation, United Nations, from their country. Means each country sends 5 delegates and have one vote. General Assembly discusses world issues and problems and recommends solutions. It also oversees the budget of the UNO. So important things are discussed in the General Assembly. They come out to the various solutions regarding the problems faced by the world, and budget formation is also done in this. Now next we have Security Council. The Security Council is the executive body of the UN. It is the most powerful and important organ of the UN. Security Council is the most important and powerful organ of the UN. Security Council has 15 members. It has 15 members. And out of that, 5 are more important. The 5 important members of Security Councils are the USA, Russia, England, France, and China. The 10 non-permanent members are elected by the General Assembly for a period of 2 years. So, 5 members are permanent members. These 5 countries are USA, Russia, China, England, France. They are the permanent members. And the 10 non-permanent members are elected by the General Assembly for a period of 2 years. Each member of the council can cast one vote. So each member can cast one vote. The Security Council maintains international peace and security. It also investigates internal disputes, recommends methods of solving disputes, takes military actions against war, wanting nations, etc. The work of Security Council is to maintain international peace. It's only, you all know that UNO is formed for maintaining peace and security. It also investigates internal disputes within the 2 countries, recommends methods of 54 member organ of the UN, performs many dignified duties, In Economic and Social Council, there are 54 members, and these 54 members, organ of the UN, performs many dignified duties. It promotes human rights and helps people all over the world to improve their standard of living. It guides the agencies of the UN and helps them work for the common good of mankind. Problems like illiteracy, problems like illiteracy, famine, and poverty are handled by the Economic and Social Council. The council meets twice every year during the months of April and July. So, students, total there are 54 members of the order, and they promote human rights and help people all over the world to improve the standard of living. It also guides agencies of the UN and help them to work for the common goal of mankind. Now we move towards the Trusteeship Council. The Trusteeship Council was founded in 1945. It is a caretaker of the territories that were not free at the time of formation of the UN. The Trusteeship Council takes care of that places or the regions which were not free at the time of the formation of UN. Many of the colonial countries are now free. This organ of the UN is not functional today. It was when the UN formation was done, it's not working. At present time, it's not working. Next, we have International Court of Justice. Yes. Students, as we have three different levels of court in India, local level, district court, state high court, and the Supreme Court, highest court in India. Same way we have International Court of Justice also. So this court is the chief court of the UN. It houses has 15 judges. Yes, the International Court of Justice has 15 judges that are elected by the General Assembly and the Security Council. So the chief judges of this International Court are elected by the General Assembly and the Security Council. The term served by these elected judges is of 9 years. Students, see, please remember, here it's the period is 9 years. In India, we have the period of courts 5 years. Here the judges serve for 9 years. The International Court of Justice is based at The Hague in Netherlands. So, the headquarters of this International Court of Justice is at Hague in Netherlands. The main aim of the World Court is to settle mutual disputes among different nations by peaceful methods. So, main aim is to settle the disputes among different nations by peaceful methods. They don't have to fight a war. Peacefully, their problems can be solved. The last organ is the Secretariat. The Secretariat looks after the administration of the UN. The head of the Secretariat is the Secretary General. The head of the Secretariat is Secretary General. Is elected by the General Assembly. Yes. The head of the Secretariat, that is Secretary General, is elected by the General Assembly. The Secretariat building is in New York, USA. It was established in 1945. The Secretariat was established in 1945. And its headquarters is New York, USA. So students, now this was about the organs of the UN. We have gone through the different organs, or six important organs of the UN.